thank you for joining us today. I'm Nicola Jones, Director of the Spring & Nature Sustainable Development Goals Programme. And today I'll be talking about research publishing and the Sustainable Development Goals, or SDGs. As you may be aware, the SDGs are a set of 17 interconnected goals adopted by all UN member states in 2015. They set out a blueprint for a sustainable future, addressing the social, economic, environmental, and health-related aspects of this challenge. More than just a set of aspirations, each of the goals has a set of targets measured by specific indicators in order that progress can be measured towards achieving them by their 2030 deadline. The world is not currently on track to achieve the goals by 2030. Much more action is needed. In 2016, Spring & Nature launched our Grand Challenges programme, which was then refocused in 2019 to more specifically address the SDGs and encourage the publication of research that can inform the development of solutions to the challenges that the goals set out to address. In 2020, the International Publishers Association launched the Sdg Publishers Compact, specifically to galvanise the wider publishing industry to address the goals, and we were an early signatory of this. And I and one of my colleagues, Aaron Kuster, are members of the Sdg Publishers Compact Fellows Group, which is working to develop resources to bring the commitments in the compact to life and help lots of publishers to address the goals through their work. So my role as director for the SDG Publishing Programme is, to the best of my knowledge, quite unique in the industry. I don't think any other publishers have anything quite like this. And it was created back in 2016 in recognition of the fact that if you're going to address the kinds of global challenges that the SDGs set out to address, you need to have insights from lots of different disciplines. But like universities, at Spring & Nature, our organisation is set up with different departments for different disciplines. So the idea was to create a central point of coordination to bring people together who were publishing content in whatever format and from whichever discipline that were addressing the same challenge. And we wanted to do this because by having this central coordination, we would be better able to help the people that need research in the real world to find, access and use it to develop solutions. So essentially, as this slide says, we set up the SDG programme to make sure that trustworthy research on important topics gets attention. And besides my role, this has been a focus of lots of people around the company, including Sir Philip Campbell, who's quoted on the slide here. He's the editor-in-chief of Spring & Nature and the former editor-in-chief of Nature, and he's right in saying that this is something that inspires lots of our colleagues. So here is how we address the SDGs at Spring & Nature. We support and amplify the goals by focusing content acquisition efforts in the relevant areas towards the SDGs. We launch new publications and develop new ways to showcase this content in order to reach more people. And our publishing isn't just research focused. We also publish Scientific American and its international editions, which help to communicate science to a much broader audience beyond academia. Innovating in support of the SDGs. So we use the goals as a focal point around which to develop new initiatives, particularly those that take advantage of our convening power to bring together groups that might not otherwise have met. And we act and operate as a sustainable business. We're committed to addressing the environmental and social impacts of our operations. We have a dedicated sustainable business team, which includes a climate action officer. We have a commitment to being carbon neutral, and we've signed up to the Science Based Targets Initiative. And Spring & Nature's wider commitment to open access publishing underpins this approach. So if we want to make sure that SDG-related content is available to those who are best placed to put it into practice, then facilitating the opening of access to that content is a really important way of doing this. But what does this mean for our publishing activities? So we've recently undertaken a thorough analysis of the market of published articles relating to the SDGs using Digital Sciences Dimensions Database, which classifies articles to the SDGs using a machine learning technique. From this, we see that approximately 12% of all articles published in 2021 related to one or more of the 17 goals. That's nearly 600,000 articles. And if we look at subscription access articles and open access articles separately, we see that a slightly higher proportion of open access articles related to the SDGs, around 14% of those, versus about 10% of subscription access articles. So articles relating to the SDGs make up a sort of smallish amount of the total market, but it's a segment that's very rapidly growing year on year as more and more articles are published on these topics. In fact, research relating to the SDGs outgrows the market for all academic articles by about 10 percentage points across each different business model. But research on the SDGs isn't an evenly distributed space. There are different amounts of papers published on each goal. And the chart here shows how many articles were published for each in 2021, with almost 80% of the research published on the SDGs relating to just five goals. That's SDG 3, Good Health and Wellbeing, SDG 7, Affordable and Clean Energy, SDG 4, Quality Education, SDG 16, Peace, Justice and Strong Institutions, and SDG 13, Climate Action. And this pretty much reflects the grant funding for projects relating to the goals that's available. And we also find that SDG-related content is more frequently cited than non-SDG-related content, regardless of whether this is published open access or not. And furthermore, we see that articles relating to the SDGs receive much higher altmetric scores than non-SDG-related articles, indicating that they gain more non-academic attention as well. So now looking at how research relating to all 17 goals breaks down by subject area, this chart's a little bit complicated, but essentially the blue bars show the number of SDG-related articles published from each discipline in 2021, with the disciplines classified by the fields of research codes and dimensions. And the points on the orange line show the proportion of research from that discipline that relates to the SDGs. So for example, we see that there are about 154,000 articles published from medicine and health sciences journals that related to at least one goal. But that's only about 11% of all the articles published in medicine and health sciences journals in 2021 in total. And comparing this with education, we see that although fewer SDG articles were published here, with 47,000 in 2021, that's actually about 43% of all the articles that were published in education journals that relate to at least one goal. And the general trend that we can identify from this is that there's a higher volume or article share of SDG-related research if a discipline is very closely linked to one of the goals. So for example, law and legal studies is very closely linked to SDG 16, Peace, Justice and Strong Institutions, and almost half of the research published in that discipline relates to a goal. Medicine and Health Sciences publishes a very large volume of articles relating to at least one goal, and that's of course very closely linked to SDG 3, Good Health and Wellbeing. And finally, I wanted to briefly mention our work with the UN Sustainable Development Solutions Network. Publishing research relating to the SDGs is all very well, and it's definitely something that we want to continue to do more of. But if the goals are to be achieved, the research needs to be translated into action. In 2020, we co-hosted a virtual conference, Science for a Sustainable Future, which invited experts to discuss how we can best bridge the gap between research and policy, along with examples of where research has been successfully translated into policy and practice to address the SDGs. So for example, through the Food Systems Dashboard, which is a collaboration between universities and NGOs. From this conference, we published a white paper, which sets out recommendations for better connecting research and policy. And three of those recommendations are to increase the translation of results of scientific assessments across all scales into practical guidance for policymakers and implementers, to raise scientific literacy and awareness of the SDGs among citizens and policymakers through greater collaboration, advocacy, and outreach, and to provide formats and forums that encourage greater breadth and integration of research across disciplines with a focus on finding solutions to global challenges. And these are all areas where journals can contribute. So we hosted a second iteration of this conference in 2021, and we're planning a third for early next year, as well as a special plenary panel discussion at the International Conference on Sustainable Development in September this year, which will look more in more depth at communication of research to the public. So I hope you've all enjoyed this tour of the publishing landscape around the SDGs and some of our activities in this area. Thank you.